Good morning, everyone, and good devach, Shavua Tov. We are continuing over here in chapter 91 of the Akitza Shulchan Aruch. And these are Din Mish Yesh Lo Mechush V'Choy L'Shem B'Sakana, someone that has some pain, discomfort on Shabbos, and a Choy L'Shem, a person that is sick. However, Ein B'Sakana, it's not a matter of life and death over here, as we've been speaking about, since that it is a small ailment that a person has. It's very limited in the treatments or the things that we're allowed to do for that person that they should feel better on Shabbos. Says the Kitzur the following. A cheshesh b'meyav, someone that has intestinal pain, he's got a stomachache. Mutelitein aleim kais shi'iro mimenu chamin. A person is allowed to take a cup of hot water and place it on his stomach. Afa b'shadayin yesh b'hevel, even though that there's still some heat and warmth that's in it. You're allowed to do such a thing. This is the old type of healing agent that they used to do. The heat that would be on this pack or this cup that would go into the intestines, it would help to open things up over there in order that you should be able to use the facilities afterwards. So to a person could warm up clothing, they could warm up garments, like a heating pack. A person will be able to warm them up, again, in the proper, appropriate way on Shabbos. For example, like you'd put it, I guess, on top of a blech, not directly on the blech, but on an overturned pan or so, and then it would warm up in such a way, or you want to put it near the blech, next to the blech, and allow them to heat up in that way. So if you could do such a thing, because the heat of those garments would help to facilitate the movement over there inside the intestines, then a person would be allowed to do such a thing. Mishen nikba yaday oy ragle. A person who ended up cutting their hand or their leg. Same so biyayin kedei la'amid adam. So a person would be allowed to, they'd be allowed to put wine or put it inside of wine in order that the blood would stop pouring out. If they cut themselves very badly and the blood was pouring out, they could do something to help stop the blood. But they cannot put it into chaymetz, in the vinegar, because vinegar is very strong. And everybody knows that the reason that he's putting the vinegar there, it's almost like an antiseptic in such a case. And there's some refuah, there's healing agent that is going on over there. If a person is a ma'unag, which means they're very delicate, they're such a delicate type of a person, then even wine is something that is going to be almost antiseptical to him, and therefore he would not be able to do that as well. It's going to have the same halachic status as chaymetz, as vinegar. If this cut is on the back of his hand, agava regal, on the back of his leg, he was cut into his body with barzel, with some kind of iron, then we're going to see in that case later on, this is much more of a sakana dika thing. This is much more of a dangerous situation when iron rips into somebody's flesh, or apparently on the back of the hand, as we'll see later on, or the back of his leg is a more dangerous place for the cut to take place. There'll be a much more leniencies in the world of refuah, of healing, in that particular case. Yesh loy, says the Kitzur, yesh loy eizem mechush ben, if a person has some kind of pain in his eye, lo yitin aleim reik tafel, he's not allowed to put spit into his eyes in order to heal them. The muchmas lefuah of it, because if he does that, the reason he is because he wants to heal himself. However, if a person doesn't have an ailment, but rather they cannot open their eyes, for some reason their eyes are glued, stuck over here, then he can smear this spit onto his eyes. He's not doing it to heal his eyes. He doesn't have any ailments in his eyes. He just can't open his eyes. Maybe he's got too much sleep in his eyes, too much mucus in his eyes, whatever it might be over there. And therefore, to open his eyes, we would allow him to do such a thing. Okay, we wish that everybody should always be healthy during the week and healthy on Shabbos so that many of these halachas will not be pertinent to them. However, we're learning the halachas because in a lifetime, a person certainly does come across people that are chaylim, that are sick upon Shabbos, and a person has to know what is permissible and what is not. Have a wonderful day, a good week, and a Shavua Tov. All the best.